It is another beautiful Saturday. Welcome to African Entertainment Series. My name is DJ Sow, and it is a great pleasure to have you join us on this show. On our last episode, I took you on a journey to Nigeria, and today I'll be bringing you back to the Senegambian region, and I'll bring you all the background information that you need to know about the late legendary Kora player and traditional griot, Lalo Kebba Drammeh. But before we get into it, let's go on a short commercial break. We'll be right back after this. Commercial break, but before we get started, let us talk about my today's outfit. It is given uniquely Gambian, exceptionally African, because the individual that I'll be profiling today is a Senegambian born. So I thought of giving you a little bit of the Senegambian vibe. Lalo Kebba Drammeh was born in the year 1926 in the Lower River region of the Gambia, Kiankouinala to be precise. But he lived most of his life in Senegal, cruising between Casamance, Guinea-Bissau, and Kolda. Lalo has two brothers, Lalo Dinding Drammeh and Kabura Drammeh. Lalo has a very deep voice when talking, but a sharp and a soft voice when singing. When I actually read about this, I doubted it, for the fact that I have been listening to so many Lalo songs. But to be honest with you, I have never imagined that he was behind those songs. His music was unanimous, transmitting oral tradition and telling stories which are often familiar with his audience. Lalo married his first wife, Njaiba, the granddaughter of Wandifin Jobate, who was a renowned Kora player and a griot. He was named the Master of Kora because of his ability to tune his Kora once, not in between lines like other jallies do. Because of his beautiful voice, Lalo used to hypnotize the then president of Senegal, Leopold Sedat Senghor, whenever he sings. And this is the reason why Leopold asked him to naturalize and become Senegalese, but Lalo declined. He was among the troop that the late president of the Gambia, Sir Daouda Kairaba Jawara, selected to represent Gambia in the Mandin Conference in London. Before leaving for the Mandin Conference in London, Lalo then married his second wife, Kurab Bissan, whom he went with to the conference, and they were announced winners and the best group to ever perform in the Mandin Conference. Lalo was a mystical person who attributes his powers to spirit and prayers. Because he disappeared from his house for 8 days. Yes, you heard me right, for 8 days. And no one could tell where he has been. And when he appeared, he said, all he could remember was his friend Malang Sabali appeared to him in his dreams and asked him to sit on his back, eyes closed, and he flew away with him. Lalo said he believed he was taken away by jinns and anointed with powers. His spiritual journey led him to compose his famous song, Jembaseng. Let's take a listen to this song. We'll be back. Thank you. beautiful song. We could tell that Lalo has been the best Kora king that ever lived. Before he left for the Mandin conference in London, Lalo then married his second wife, Kurambisa. The legendary Kora player died shortly after the Mandin conference in London in 1974, and he was buried in Dakar, Senegal. Until his demise in 1974, Lalo was married to his beautiful wife, Kurambisa, and his songs are well alive in the beautiful voice of Kura, which could be heard during her performance with RTS, a national TV station in Senegal, and also the National Ensemble of Senegal. After making this research, I believe he should be celebrated by every Gambian because he was undoubtedly the best Kora king that ever lived. This has been African Entertainment Series coming to you every Saturdays at African Renaissance TV. Make sure you leave a comment under this post and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you.